I'm an environmental microbiologist, and what that means is I study microorganisms that are in the environment. In 1 gram of soil, there can be over 1 trillion cells, and it can have over 10,000 different species. In fact, you have at least 10 times more bacterial cells in your body than you have human cells. So understanding how they work together and how the most abundant life on Earth works is really important to me. And in general, we just want to have a better understanding of how these things work and the whole ecosystem. Gulf of Mexico has 400,000 to a million barrels of oil that go into the Gulf of Mexico every year from natural seeps. So if I had to look for oil degrading bacteria, this would have been the place. And so, in fact, we found oil degrading bacteria. It wasn't really that surprising to us, but it was to a lot of other people. And that's why we've seen the oil go away quite fast. It's using biological techniques to and biological mechanisms to degrade a particular contaminant to make it non-toxic. Hopefully we'll figure out very cost-effective ways to remediate some of the most toxic compounds known to man. Well, of course, the first thing would be to make all the energy requirements for the remediation to be nil. So to be neutral in terms of we're generating enough bioenergy or enough energy to cancel out any energy costs that we have in terms of remediation. And so that's one of the things I think probably more and more I'll be trying to do is sort of marry the bioenergy with the bioremediation, so we can do those things simultaneously.